Hey everyone, I'm Tammy and welcome to my YouTube channel where I'll be discussing all things coding, careers and lifestyle. And in this particular video, I'm going to be talking about the 100 Days of Code Challenge. And if you don't know what that is, it's a challenge where you commit to coding for 100 days straight, where you code for at least an hour a day. So in this video, I'm going to be going over the technical and non-technical things I learned, as well as the projects I built, and also I'll be addressing some questions I got on Instagram. And if you don't already follow me on there, you can find my Instagram handle here, as well as Twitter and my other social media. So make sure to follow me on there. So a quick overview of my tech background. I didn't know any coding language properly before I started this. I had an idea of Python and MATLAB because I have an undergraduate degree in geology and physics. So my second year of physics, I learned Python, but the lecturer kind of threw a manual at us and said, do the assignment. So I knew how to use Python for assignments. I didn't really know Python. So during my master's a few years later, I learned MATLAB. I took a computational module where we used MATLAB for data visualization and I really enjoyed that. So that's kind of how I got into tech. I'm on a technology graduate scheme and I'm currently a graduate software developer. So the main reason I decided to do this challenge was to really prepare me for the role which I've now started. So the first non-technical thing I learned was to be aware of your learning style. If you're learning in a way that suits you best, you're way more likely to stick to the challenge and actually finish it. So for me, I'm a visual learner, which means I learn best by seeing things done in front of me. Therefore, I decided to follow some Udemy courses and also YouTube tutorials. So I would just really suggest you find out what your learning style is and adapt your learning to that. The second thing I learned was to prioritize time. I'm aware that some people might have kids, hobbies, or full-time jobs, but the main thing is to set aside a realistic amount of time every day. If you know you can only do half an hour, commit to that half an hour. For me, the best time to code was actually straight after work. And once I got used to coding at a specific time every day, I was way less likely to skip days because it became part of my everyday routine that it just felt odd or weird if I wasn't coding. So the third thing is to structure your learning. Have a plan before you sit down and you decide to start coding. That way you have something to work towards and you're determined to finish it and make sure that plan is achievable. The fourth thing is to make notes as you go. This kind of goes without saying. It just means that you're putting what you're learning into your own words, which means you're more likely to retain and actually understand the information. The fifth thing is to join a supportive platform. That could be Twitter, it could be Instagram. So just join a platform where you can speak to other people. If you need help, you can reach out to people and get advice from them. The next thing is to take breaks. I know this might be a bit controversial given the rules of the challenge, but if you're having an off day, then take a break. It's not going to diminish all the achievements you've made so far. The main goal of the 100 Days of Code Challenge is to make coding a long-lasting habit. So, moving on to the section that I'm sure you guys have been waiting for, the technical things I learned. The first things I learned were front-end languages, HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. I followed two Udemy courses. One was pure JavaScript, and the other one was a full Web Developer Bootcamp kind of course. So that included both front-end languages, back-end languages, and frameworks as well. And the reason I chose these two courses is because the role I'm in now, we actually use JavaScript and Node.js and Express. So I kind of wanted to structure my learning around my next role. But I would also suggest if you're a beginner to start off with front-end. But if you guys want me to go into more detail about what languages are best to learn as a beginner, just let me know and I'll definitely do that for you. In terms of frameworks, I learned Bootstrap 3, where you use HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. I also learned React Native. I took part in a month-long hackathon with four other girls. So I was in a team of five and we built a prototype app. And then I also learned Express and Semantic UI. So in terms of backend, I learned the command line APIs and REST APIs. I learned MongoDB, Mongoose, and also authentication. I also got familiar with Git and GitHub. So I learned how to build my own repositories, set up my own projects, and also deploy projects to GitHub. And I also got familiar with Postman, which is an application which you use to test and debug HTTP APIs. So my main stack throughout this was MERN. So MongoDB, Express, React or React Native, and also Node.js. So, projects I created, what I created. So in total, I created 5 main projects. The first one was a React Native app. As I mentioned earlier, I took part in a remote month-long hackathon in May. I was in a team of 5. Together, we created a React Native app using only front-end technologies. So we use HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and React Native. The second thing I created was a static web page, and that was basically just a landing page, and I used HTML, CSS, and JavaScript again in Bootstrap. It was just getting familiar with creating nav bars, the drop-down menu as well, and figuring out how to make a website responsive. The next major project I built was a color game project. So that was a RGB color guessing game, which was useful for practicing RGB colors, if you're not familiar with that. And again, that was made using HTML, JavaScript, CSS, and Bootstrap 3. The next major project I built was a RESTful blog application. So it was an application that lists different books written by Black authors. And that was built using Node.js, CSS, and HTML in Semantic UI. And the idea of that is it's just a blog where you have different book reviews and the user can add a new book review, you can edit book reviews, or you can delete book reviews. The last major project I built was a Yelp camp site. So the idea of that, it was a kind of website which lists different campsites and you can find out information about it and navigate through the website. So next I'm going to be answering the questions I got via Instagram. So the first question I got was, when you get stuck, where do you go? Especially as a self-taught developer, and if YouTube is still confusing, I would usually maybe look for blogs online. So I would just Google whatever the thing I was having issues with was. Most likely there's someone's written a blog on that. Or also, like I mentioned earlier, join supportive platforms. So if you need help, you can message people in a Discord group, in a Slack group, on Twitter, on Instagram. I did that a lot. The next question I got was, why did I decide to focus on backend? And like I said earlier, I'm a graduate software developer and the team I'm in mainly deals with backend stuff. So that's APIs, etc., all that good stuff. The next question I got was, how do I focus on one language, a language that I can learn properly? I think the best way to focus on one language is to have a plan. If you know that, okay, I want to learn front end, I want to build websites, the 3 main things that you really should be focusing on are HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. So I would then follow a course either online or through books or whatever it is, focusing on one of those 3. And then when you feel comfortable enough, when you feel like you've understood it, then I would move on. The next question was, how did you keep yourself so motivated to finish the 100 days throughout? If you structure your learning, if you set aside some time and also take breaks, I didn't code for 100 days straight. I had a few days out here and there when I wasn't feeling so good or if I was quite busy. Another question I got was, after you learn all the fundamentals, how do you know you're ready to move on to frameworks? Build projects, that's really a good way to consolidate your learning. I remember in the beginning, I was so caught up with, oh, I need to learn all the syntax. I need to make sure I know everything about JavaScript or whatever it is. But the best way that you're going to learn is by doing things and by putting what you've learned to actual work. So that was it, guys. I hope this video was helpful. I really hope that if you were considering learning how to code, that you decide to take the leap and do that after watching this video. And watch out for my future videos where I will be talking about how to get into tech without a computer science degree, postgraduate degrees, doing a master's, whether or not it's right for you, graduate jobs, and everything in between. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment, and also hit the notification bell so anytime I put out a new video, you'll know straight away. Bye.